So today, went and got myself a new winch. We'll see what it comes with. Sorry about the wind. Comes with a manual. Winch controller. Red little lead for the hook. Mounting hardware. I'm guessing that's the relays. Hook for the front. Battery cable. Loads of styrofoam. Roller fair lead. Doesn't look half shabby for this Hazard Frost, I'm sorry, Harbor Freight. Quality winch. Comes with the control pack. I think, I don't really know what it's called. Not bad. And comes with the winch. I think that's about it. So today, I think I'm going to mount this on up here. The question is, which way do I want it?
I think I'll want it that way.
Should I read the instructions, or should I just go crazy? I think I'm going to actually mount roller fair lead first, and then the control box onto the winch. I'm going to set this aside. Okay. Got the roller fair lead. Still got to unwrap everything. The controller feels kind of cheaply made. So does the hook, though. Forged 3/8. Well, we'll see. All right, we'll look at the manual. All the hardware is there. 6 4 bolts. Metric 8.8. Do I believe that? No. Yeah, 8.8. I think those are 3/8 equivalent. Okay. We'll throw this on real fast. Only one way it goes on this darn Jeep. So do I want the washer on the front? Yeah, I'll put the washer on this one. Flat washer. Don't know if that's really going to make a difference. Lock washer and nut. washer and nut. And I'm really hoping this fills out the front end of the vehicle a little better. Looking kind of lonesome up here without a winch on it. So, just so the wind doesn't carry that away. That'll be a lot of fun putting the Oh, I did say they were metric, didn't I? Huh. 19. Yeah, it's pretty much where it's going to sit. I don't really have a choice with this bumper. And we'll just torque it down good and tight. Okay. Yeah, color coded. That's fantastic. Black, yellow, red, black, yellow, red, and I believe this one goes underneath. Alright, I'll check the angle. Yes. The one with the black goes on black, the one with the yellow goes on the yellow. The one with the red goes on the red. And the long red goes to this. And this goes to your battery. This is the circuit breaker. And then this goes on the bottom with this one. The bottom lug down here to the battery. Looks like it can be done that way. Wonderful. So, let me get to it. That's about 6 feet there.
Oh, I didn't even realize you were out of frame. My apologies. I put that whole thing on without realizing you weren't even in frame. So far I mounted the roller fairlead.
Now I'm working on mounting the winch. Should be relatively simple to put together. Now, I've heard different reviews about these winches. Now, since I'm not hooking it up to the battery quite yet, I'll just kind of snake these around and get them kind of put the way they look good on. Wires all tangled up. Bring that back. There we go.
the size of this real fast. Second. I think these ratcheting box wrenches were one of the greatest inventions ever. It's nice and snug, nice and tight. Shouldn't have any shorts. That thing is definitely not light. I don't know what way's easier to do is either mount these right now or put this on first. I don't like how that styrofoam stuck to that. What do you think? Right there in the middle? I think that'll make it look pretty good. And I'll finish tightening those down in a minute. I really hope these don't get in the way of my grill and cause problems. Tighten up these screws back fast.
Alright.
I don't know where the camera cut me off there. I heard it do its famous little beeping before it cuts me off. Yellow. I mean, that's pretty simple how they set that up, so it's not terribly hard to figure out how it goes together. I don't know why I might mess with somebody pretty bad to swap those two around. Boot cover over this. My word. I don't know. I don't know if it's supposed to be that tight or not. Oh my. Alright, I'll bring you back once I get that over. Alright, so I got the, boot on. All I did was take a pair of needle nose and it stretched right over without tearing, surprisingly. Seems to like that. I'll let it go where it's heavy.
on this one. If it struggles with me, I'll show you how to do the other one, which it's going to. Just a pair of nails. And over. Wiggle it around. Yeah, you know. Give it the protection it needs. So that's in.
Now, we take you off the tripod here, and I'll show you what I'm how I mount this. I don't know if you can see in there, the little holes right there where those square nuts go. So I have a feeling these go like that. So. I don't know if these go like this, if it focus, with this here, and then like that when we mount it. So let's check the instructions. Come on, focus. Focus. There we go. That's the hardware it comes with. I've got to figure out whether or not this winch bumper will hold this winch. So, I'll bring you back once I have it mounted. Well, I decided to show you on the last one what I'm doing. I stacked the flat washer, lock washer, and then medium strength Loctite. Take the square nut and you try not to drop it where you can't reach it like I just did. Size here it takes, which is a 16 millimeter. Go underneath. Now, when I looked in the manual, it didn't tell me torque specifications. That's one reason why I'm using Loctite. I may need an extension for how this bumper's set up. Remember, you can't always pull your tool. Hold that one. They definitely, the manufacturer of this bumper did a really good job. Socket on the ratchet. Nice. If you can't pull your tool, push with an open hand. I've learned the hard way. It's a bit tight. The Loctite should prevent it from going too crazy. Now this bumper has the unibody tie-ins compared to some of the other brands out there that don't come with it. You have to order it separately. I'd have to say this bumper probably weighs about 300 pounds. It's heavy. It was no easy task putting it on here by myself. So, I don't think that's going anywhere.
All right, let me pick up this mess of tools and I'll get right back with you for the wiring. So what I did is I ran them underneath, up through in front of the battery. Now I'm about to hook it up. So, let me find the size. I believe, if I remember correctly, let's try 10 millimeters. No, 12.
No.
Wow, I'm terrible today.
Yeah, 11.
Hopefully it won't fry everything here. Oh, that was already loose. Oh my. We'll hold the nut down there. Now, this is probably not the best way to hook it up. But I do plan on putting dual batteries and better connectors in here a little later. And to put dual batteries in here, it's going to entail me taking out the air box and putting in a cone filter. And now, if I was smart, I would remove the negative terminal before I even think about playing with the positive. But let's see if I'm lucky enough and I don't shock the heck out of myself. How about that? This should be quite fun. I think we'll do it like that. Flat. Nah, that's 13. Give me one second. Seems like everything on this is... Yep. I may have to loosen that up. Oh my. Is that gonna hit? Yeah, it's gonna hit things that way. See, and I knew I was gonna run into this problem. I'm really not comfortable having those open like that in the engine compartment like that. That makes me nervous. Seems to be the only way it really wants to go in. But that's a negative cable right there. And if I hit that, if it rubs down the road, it's going to be one heck of a ride. Yeah, excuse my nasty wiring in here. Like I said, all this is temporary. Because this battery's about to die anyways. It's not very good. It's relatively old. I'm amazed it even still works. If I change the angle of this, maybe I should have done that in the first place. Not like I know what I'm doing here. Don't want this cable hitting anything. So if I change the angle, it still really likes right there. I guess I'll put it there and wrap this in electrical tape. I don't think that's gonna hurt it. Could be wrong. Well, let me wrap it in electrical tape first. Let me go get some. Give me one second. I just don't feel comfortable enough leaving this bear. Well, that bear. I mean, if these relays get hot, they'll melt it. I wish these were insulated a little better. I don't know if that's just the way that this winch is, or if that's all winches. Maybe that's where they cut corners to make these things so darn cheap. Old rolls of electrical tape. If I ever need to replace these, it's not terrible to remove electrical tape. It is kind of bad, but not terrible. So let's see where that wants to sit. Happy. Yep, right there. Let me tighten that one back up. Fingers first. There we go. Alright. Now let's not kill myself with the, that's loose too. Why are these all loose? Well, maybe it's a good thing I'm going in here and doing this. Just set it there for now so I can get my finger out from underneath before I rearrange it. Now remember, I did not disconnect the negative terminals, so we'll see if I can do this without shocking myself. Let's finish removing this and we'll route this slightly different. Kind of around the battery, not over the battery. I do have a little more slack if I need it. Oh, I think I'm loaded too. I got the ground wire over there too, so. That doesn't look half bad. And we'll tighten back down the battery and, well, maybe. I'm missing, I guess that's partly why I'm missing pieces. It's one reason why I want to do a battery upgrade. And I might do an alternator upgrade sometime.
Let me put these tools away and we'll see if the winch functions. I think it works. I think that might just suit my needs. We'll hook it up over here to the shackle and call it good from there. Alrighty. Well, I think that's about all I'm doing today. So, thanks for watching. Comment if you like, subscribe if you like. Thank you.